Okay, guys, welcome. This is actually starting the new group, the new session. So tonight we're going to be doing, we're going to start with, this is going to be a different format than what you guys have been here before. It's going to be like an open discussion. So it's going to be deal presentation and pitch decks. My intention, what I'm working on right now, is trying to invite all the lenders. You know, we have 10 or 12 people that lend, or they broker, you know, some, you know, we got, I know Willie's got his, I know we got a, Simi's got some programs, Bill Johnson, Mel, Gabe, all those people. So we want to start getting our internal people on here talking about the programs they represent and they can do for people, how they can help you guys with your deals, as well as the lenders that are on the 20,000. So I'm going to kind of give you guys a real quick update because I want to get through these updates on the recording fast, and then we'll turn it off and we'll talk. So with the 20,000 contacts, you guys know there's we got the 1.0 out. We've had it Wednesday night. I will go through the 1.0 probably for the last time because the 2.0 is ready. Now here's what's going to happen with the 2.0. Because if you guys have just seen the list of all the databases that I have now to include at the 3.0, there's several that are real estate oriented. The ones that are family offices and hedge funds and stuff like that that we have. What I'm going to do is have the 2.0. The 3.0 is going to come out. It's just going to be all the real estate. It's going to be the three databases we have now that you guys have seen on the 1.0. And it's going to be all of the real estate databases. So there's going to be like 10,000. So there's 10 databases. It's not going to be enough room. You know, it's going to be a download nightmare if we have all 20,000 contacts. So I'm going to break it up and everybody's going to get the 3.0. And then we're not going to call it the 4.0. We're just going to do the 3.0 is going to have two parts. The other one's going to have all the family offices, the hedge funds, pension funds, endowment funds. Now, because we also have, in addition to all the real estate stuff, and you guys may or may not need this, but who knows if you guys are run across people or whatever, it's going to also have medical, healthcare investors. It has venture capitalists, technology, food, and, you know, a lot of other stuff besides real estate. So I want to make the 3.0, which is all real estate. So the three lender databases and all, we have known investors for REITs. We have known investors for fix and flips, for multifamily. These are known, and you guys will have not only all the contact information and what they do, but you also have the CSVs. We don't have CSVs for the lenders. We do for these investors. CSVs are great because you can actually you can go to LinkedIn, you can take them and you can import them to LinkedIn. If you import all 20,000 contact, I mean, without the lender ones, there's about 1,000 of them. Without the lender ones, you can import them into LinkedIn. Really, within about 30 days, there's a little bit of work to do because you guys know on LinkedIn, you kind of got to manually accept, you know, contacts and connections and all that. Within 30 days, you probably have 5,000 friends and stuff, contacts at hedge funds and pension funds. And that's what I call a soft pull. So this is available to everybody. Marty, I'm also going to kick all this out to the PMA people. We're going to invite everybody into this group. And then, so that's what we're going to be doing with the 2.0, guys. So the 2.0, the 3.0 will come out. That way you guys have all the real estate. Everything's separate for real estate because that's what you guys are doing. And then you don't have to dick around with somebody who just does medical or food or technology or something. There's some Silicon Valley people in there. They're not doing real estate. So you're going to have every real estate. Now, what we also have talked about, you guys have seen me post. I know, Willie, you're interested in it. I know Simi, you and Simi were just talking about it. Guys, we have about a number of our lenders that are looking for brokers. So if you are brokering now, that's cool. If you want a broker, I just put those links into the group. But right now, Togo has gone with Civic and with Rock. Rock Capital was started in 2009 by two guys from Deutsche Bank. They've lent over $8 billion as of now. They have combined forces to put a correspondent lending together. So if you get a broker, now you become a correspondent lender. And they're going to do credit lines. And you guys know how the mortgage warehouse lines work. So they're going to have 7 million, 10 million, 25 million lines. I don't know exactly how that's going to work. We got a few people contacting this week. So I'll get some feedback from them to actually on how people can be a correspondent lender. I don't think it's going to be like you create your own program. And I think they're going to create it with you. So that way they have some underwriting and oversight because it's their money. But it's a phenomenal program because you might get to be able to, you can present it to people you know as a lender rather than being a broker, and that gives you a lot more credibility. And it's going to be totally white label. There's a little bit of Tamwin put something on the post that was kind of wrong. This is correspondent lending. When they do some other table funding, they will sometimes have a little thing with, say, this is, you know, them, and you know, you've got your website, your big logo and all that stuff. If you need one, get with Zeeshan. But if you're a correspondent lender, it is your font. I mean, you can represent yourself as a lender. They're going to do all the underwriting, all the process and transaction stuff behind the scenes. They're going to be using Civics. So Kogo has obviously the biggest group of private money brokers, including myself. Obviously they've got money, but Rock 360 has the deep pockets. You know, they've done $8 billion in, you know, 15, you know, so 2009. So going on almost, you know, what is it, 15 years or so, getting close to that. And then Civic has some phenomenal of the table funding kind of software, the white label stuff. So they're going to combine with that. I don't know what the onboarding process, the qualifications are. If you want to do it, but you don't quite qualify, guess what? That's what the next 20 weeks is going to help you guys probably get better position understanding it. So the schedule is going to be this Monday nights, we're going to be doing deal desk, we're going to deal presentation, pitch decks, discussion. We're not going to record anything on Monday nights anymore. I'm going to record maybe a half an hour, 45 minutes a night. Take out a recording last time we ever record a Monday. Wednesdays will actually be the next 3 weeks. So this week and then the rest of June will be fast track for all you guys that want to broker, lend, you know, and all you guys want to make money. We've been working on it. So that's going to be my focus, is getting you guys up, getting your brands, getting your entities, getting you guys into the lenders. If you're going to broker, if you're going to be able to do correspondent lending, have you all fast track. And then we're going to take obviously July 3rd and July 5th off. And then we come back on July 10th and July 12th. We're going to start the 8th, part one. So if you guys have seen that syllabus, it's going to start part one on June. July 10th. And then July 12th and July 10th is going to start part one. We're going to go 8 weeks. Then we're going to do the analyzers for about 2 or 3 weeks. And then we're going to do another 8 weeks. We're going to do part two. We're going to finish about November 16th, which will be that Wednesday before the Wednesday of Thanksgiving week. So we're totally done with everything by that point. And then, so that's going to be kind of the schedule, guys. We're going to stick to the syllabus. I'm going to try to get everything to you guys on Monday for Wednesday. Monday, I'm probably not going to put out very much, but I'm going to list the materials you guys will need for Wednesday. This Wednesday, I'm going to really quick touch on, I'm going to do 1.0, show you guys just one more time. Then we do that session with Doris and Zeke and Willie, you guys are here. We do that. We're going to do one more quick run on it before I give you guys a 2.0. And then we're going to ship the 1.0 is gone because you're going to have the 2.0. And then we're going to basically do entity, LLCs, corporations, basically client engagement letter that you use if you're a broker. That way you can modify it, make it your own, borrower's checklist. And then, like I said, fast track through June. So you're going to get all the paperwork you need, the broker presentation, you're going to get the underwriting presentation we do. Those are both on PowerPoint and all that stuff. So it's fast track. That way you guys are all signed up and you are making money. But I know, Doris, you've been asking me for, you know, to get you in there. Will, you're already doing your thing. Sammy, you're doing yours. Spencer's back, guys. Spencer's returning. He's been resisted a couple months. So got Spencer back. Robert's new. Yeah, guys, because it's like what happened, Zeke, too, is like you guys came on later. We did a lot of this stuff in January and February. And now I'm trying to wrap it all the way around. The correspondent lending program as the goal. That is, should be a goal. Imagine how much power you go if you can broker for 10 lenders, and now you're a correspondent lender. And now you can lend money and you can actually make decisions yourself. You don't have, yeah. Which is going to be more powerful, because guys, right now we have a DSCR. I know you guys were talking about that a minute ago. You and Sammy were talking about that, Willie. But, you know, this DSCR is, everybody's asking for them in the groups. If you guys go to the Real Estate Investor Network, if you guys go to Jim Ingersoll's group, shit, they just went over 305,000 people last week. So Jim's got a lot of people, and I think I can get you guys in there where, you know, if you guys need to, people are looking for DSCR, go to Lending One right now. I know, Simi, you broke it for Lending One, so maybe you can shed a little bit more light. I haven't done anything with them since before the pandemic, but I got that email, and they're doing DSCR 6.89%, you know. They're gonna onboard you guys. They're gonna teach you how to do it. They're not just gonna turn you on blind. But if you guys can do DSCR and you can broker for Lending One, and then we'll find some other lenders that do it, man, everybody's making money. Sammy, do you want to touch on that real quick? Because I know you're with Lending One right now.
Yeah. I mean, I joined them actually before the pandemic, And I haven't closed a loan with them probably about a year, year and a half, but they've got their processes in check. They're very broker friendly. Once you go through the onboarding process, they'll set you up with an account and you can go in and you can pre-qual deals and you can print out a term sheet from there as well. So, and then once that's, and once you get that agreed upon, you can go ahead and start a file online. Yeah. So yeah, there in terms of processes and systems with respect to other lenders, they're the better ones.
Yeah, they're good. Visio's good. Kogo's notoriously for paperwork and paperwork and paperwork.
Yeah, I haven't signed up with Kogo, but yet.
Well, the correspondent program, it might be something you want to look at too.
Yeah, for sure. I'm definitely interested in that.
Because I mean, you got Kogo Rock and Civic, and Civic was rumored to be a business. Civic basically fired their CFO. And they are working with, they made some changes, obviously, in their C-suite. And they are working with now with Kogo and Rock. And we just pointed that out because Willie's been trying to get hold of Rock for a couple of weeks. And I'm like, it's really rare for those guys to go off book or go off grid. Because those guys are, you know, Rock, they've been around since, you know, they came out of Doce. They've been around. They did almost $8 billion in loans.
Not to digress, but my question there would be, so if you've got Rock and you've got Visio and Kogo, right, together? Or is that Visio and
Rock, Civic, and Kogo?
Civic. So then you've got three different lending programs. How are they going to, are they going to combine them into one lending program, or?
For the correspondence lending. And I just got that email from Gary, who's the VP of brokers at Kogo. He's the guy that actually did my private money broker training back in 2017-18. So Gary sent that out and I said, man, I'm jumping all over this because I wanted to, you know, I was trying to do it myself before the pandemic and with Rock and stuff. And it's like, you know, I wanted to, now that they're supposedly using Civic's got some really good software for white label and some processes. Rock's got the deep pockets. Kogo's got the biggest network of private money brokers because they're the ones, besides me, they're the ones, I mean, they're doing it. I took mine through them. So they've got the biggest group of private money brokers, and they've also probably got a lot of staff. It sounds like they're running it. The division manager is out of Kogo, so he's going to be out of Coeur d'Alene, Idaho. They've got, that's a guy I got his name. I'll give you guys, anybody wants, I'll put his name in the tomorrow or something. I'll put it up for you guys. But you know, if you guys get Visio, Kogo, Ground Floor, Lending One, Lima One, Briscoe's back to being a family office, so they're not, that's the one I did that big deal that you guys sometimes see me pop up in on, whatever it is. It wasn't Lee Arnold partnered with another company, and they send it, people ask me, like every 2 weeks somebody will come up and go, hey, did you really pull this deal up? It's like, you know, they partnered with another company that does one of their classes or whatever, and they show my testimonial. Like the first time I ever saw that, I'm like, I didn't do it with them. Then I found out that they actually run their seminars for them now. So they use my testimonial, but yeah, dude. So guys, you guys got to get in with these if you want to make money. And so that's why I'm going to do the fast track, because everybody's like, I got to make money. A couple of people that are coming on that are new that we've just brought in, that are, some are going to be here tonight, some may not, but they want to make money. Everybody wants to make money. So I'm going to fast track it. I made that modification, guys, because everybody's hungry for money. Everybody wants to get making money, and you know, everybody's, should I see Willie all day long talking to people about deals? I think I probably saw you post about 30 times at different groups today. Yeah. You guys, Willie's all over the place, man. You'll see him in almost every group. And I'm like, if he doesn't beat me to it, it's usually Michael Steele. Michael Steele is all over the place. You know, I've known Michael 6 years now. He's one of the first guys I was competing against, but I actually respected because I knew that, you know, he's not one of the jerks out there. There's a lot of them. And so I'm getting a lot of good feedback too, because we have a couple of people in our group that have said, hey, you had a better deal than the Gator program. And I'm getting more value from, instead, I didn't have to spend $8,000. And the other one is, I've had three people in the last 4 days call me, you know, literally contact me about, hey, can I talk to your associates and see if they want to be a Gator lender? And I'm like, I'm pretty much sure they joined me not to be a Gator lender. So guys, like I said, I'm pretty excited. So I just want to get those kind of thing out of the recording, and then I'll take it off recording, and then we can all start talking about deals. I know, Eugene, you got a couple deals. If you guys have deals going right now, you want to talk about, or if you want to talk, I'll just go around the room. So I'm going to take it off the recording. And then this will be the last time I think I ever record a Monday. If somebody, just then I'll leave this on there. just in case you guys can't make a Monday, but you need to make a presentation, we can do a private Zoom, and then I'll get it to the lenders. So you don't have to, you know, for some reason, if you can't make it on a Monday or something. And then Wednesday nights, when all the, it's really when all the education, it's going to be a completely different format that we've done.